you for getting up early to come in and see us. Actually, they're probably just coming to see Chrissy Swan. Lady Pants.
Hi, darling.
You've been so busy, spelling bee,
yes,
all the rest of it.
Yes, isn't it wonderful? Beautiful TV show.
W-O-N-D-E-R-F-U-L. Wonderful.
I think that's right. I don't know. I'm the host, not the pronouncer.
Well, it's great to have you back on the panel.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
And back with us. Let's get into our hot topics. And Jacqui Lambie hit the headlines this week when she revealed her son is battling an ice addiction. Some thought it was brave, but others have questioned the damage it might do to him. Journalist Miranda Devine put it this way. She said, "That's not tough love. That's throwing your son under the bus." Chrissy, what do you make of that?
You know, it's hard, isn't it? When I first heard Jacqui Lambie talking about it, I thought, fantastic, because ice is obviously a massive issue. Mm-hmm. And I thought, good, someone's bringing it out. And then I stopped and I thought, oh, hang on. It's not really her story to tell. Mm-hmm. So her son has a very serious addiction to ice, and she has said that there is no relationship with him anymore, that he really isn't her son, he's just an addiction. Mm. So that's obviously how she's justifying talking about it like this. But it's not her story to tell.
Yeah.
If she was addicted to ice, then that's different.
But sometimes when you're a mother, you'll do anything to try and save your son. I mean, he is, she said, a drug.
Mm.
And she made the point that even though she's a senator in the federal parliament, she cannot do anything to help her son. She cannot get him admitted to rehab, even though she knows that. So it's really a mother's cry for help for her son.
I think she had no option. Yeah, it is tricky because she is in a position to make real change for both her situation
and others,
and the situation of thousands of people. But I think for me, my family relationship comes first.
Well, I think she did put her family relationship first, because there is no relationship, because the boy is addicted and she's looking for some way to help him. And I think this was the cry of a very desperate mother.
Mm. And also as well, I think it is her story because it's her family story. She was talking from the perspective of a mum feeling absolutely helpless and what can I do to try and reach my son. She brought it up within the parliament when they were looking at laws to change whether or not
payments
and things. So she initially brought it up in that context. Mm-hmm. So that is her experience that that she's battling with. So I do think she's entitled to do that because it's her family.
It's a very personal thing.
It's a hard one.
It's out for there for the whole country now.
Even if you look at sort of what some of the practical ramifications may be, if he does clean up his act and he does get all sorted out, you know, what if he goes for a job and everyone goes, oh, it's Mr. Lambie, is it? Oh, I've read about you. I mean, when are you just going to, you know, bugger off and start, you know, smoking ice again?
We don't
know that.
But that's not really. I don't think how people in the community react. And he's young, and if she doesn't get help for him, he might die. Mm,
yeah, look, I understand it. I certainly understand. Like, she's trying to basically.
She's at her wit's end.
Of course, I completely understand that. And she wants a system where she can basically compulsorily commit him to a rehabilitation centre. If
but
heaven
people
forbid,
say that shouldn't happen. But,
yeah, that's right. So, there's all these sorts of issues here, and maybe it's not her story to tell, but it is her money that he stole. Mm, you know, is her house.
Yeah, but I think it is her story because it's her family's experience. It's what that they have lived with and what she's lived with. And I think it's resonated so deeply because there are countless families across the country dealing with issues of addiction.
And the number is growing every single day.
And there was
it's
no
a
doubt.
Huge problem.
So she spoke emotionally and she clearly loves her son.
Mm.
I mean, it's a terrible choice to have to make. Mm. How do I save my boy?
Mm. Yeah, that's a really interesting one. I can't find a right answer.
No, absolutely not.